Okay, let me show you how to transfer things or to transform a graph. And so here's a basic one with a quadratic. And here's how I'm going to deal with it. So if I have this quadratic, the first thing I need to figure out is what was its parent function. And so I can see that it is a quadratic, and I kind of spoiled that one, but it's a quadratic. So its parent function I'm going to call here, I'll call it f of a, and I'm going to say that that's equal to a squared. So I'm just writing it like this. I don't want to use x because they already use x here, and I'm just going to call it a, and this is the parent function. Let's go through how I can know how to transform this numerically. And again, I know you could probably look at some of these features here, but I'll show you that you can apply this to any graph. So here's what I do. What I do is I pick the value. So I'm going to have here a. I'm also going to have f of a. And I pick some values that are nice and simple. So if I look at this graph right here, I'm going to say, well, let's suppose I give negative 2. I'm going to pick 5 points here. If I punch in negative 2, I get 4. If I punch in negative 1, and again, negative 1 squared, I get 1, 0, you get 0, 1, 1, and then 2, 4. So it looks something like this, like a basic quadratic. What I want to do here now is to see what happens as this becomes this graph. Okay, here's the parent function. Here's some key features of it. Now let's transform it, and here's how I do it. What I do is I say, well, what will be x? Okay, that's going to go right here. What's x here in this one? And I have to relate it back to a squared. How I do that is I look at what is the only thing that's causing x to change, okay, or the horizontal. Well, this negative 2 right here will only affect the y. What's affecting the x is inside here, okay, that negative 1. And so what I do, in fact, is I say, well, let's set a equal to what's inside right here, which is x minus 1. And now I move it around and solve for x, in which case I'm going to get that x is equal to a plus 1. And this formula right here is what I'm going to use to solve for x. And so I know that when a equals negative 2 right here, if I plug in that, I'm going to get negative, so x will equal, I'll just show you my work here, it's going to be negative 2 plus 1, which is equal to negative 1. There's my first entry. And I'll keep doing that. For negative 1, when I punch it in, I get 0. When I do 0, I punch it in, I get 1. When I do 1, I get 2. And when I do 2, I get 3. This is kind of what we would expect because, again, of the shifting here. And you can see actually that it is shifting it to the right every point. Before it was negative 2, now negative 1. And they're all moving 1 to the right. Now let's take a look at what is, and this is my new function, my new parent function was g of x. Okay? Which, just a reminder here, is this function that's negative 2. X minus 1 squared. Now, when you look at this one here, you might know graphically that the only thing that's going to affect this y will be right here, this negative 2. All of this inside is shifting it horizontally, but this will affect it vertically. And so this is what I'm expecting. Let's see if I'm right though. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take the transform value negative 1, which is my first one here. Okay, before I got negative 2, 4, now I'm going to get negative 1 something. Let's find out what happens when I plug it in. Okay, or substitute. What I'm going to get here is if I plug in negative 1, okay, just to show you're going to get negative 1 minus 1, which is negative 2, and that's going to be squared, which is 4. But that 4 is times negative 2, and I'm going to get negative 8. I like this answer because if I check back, I'm noticing here that this result right here, and I'll walk you back through it, this result is really, okay, it's really negative 2 of f. And instead of x here, it was really of x minus 1. This is what I'm doing to this graph. In other words, I'm shifting it to the right, which is what's happening here. And I'm multiplying the function itself by negative 2. This is how to rewrite this in terms of f of x, which is right here. So this is negative 8. Let's see what happens when I put 0 in. If I put 0, it's going to be negative 1 squared, which is 1, times negative 2, and I get negative 2. This is great because I can check here, yeah, this is what should be happening. It should be negative 2 times this answer. Let's see what happens when I put 0 in there. Well, you're going to get, I'm sorry, when I put 1 in there. When I put 1, you're going to get 1 minus 1, which is 0, times negative 2, and I get 0. And again, this is what we'd expect. It should be 0 because 2, negative 2 times 0 is still 0. Let's try 2. When I punch in 2, you're going to get 2 minus 1, which is 1 squared, and that'll be negative 2. All of this is helping verify, and of course this one here, you're going to get 2 squared, and so I should get negative 8. And you'll notice this is great because it's negative 2 times each of these values, which is what we would expect anyways. But I'm not using that. What I'm doing is using that as a check to see if I'm right by plugging it into the values that I got. Now I can graph this thing very easily by saying the previous one were these values. So if I had negative 2, it was at 4, so it's somewhere over here. This one was at 1, negative 1 right there, 0, 0, 1, 1, and then 2, 8. And so this was my parent function, which was, again, just to remind you, that's x squared. My new function, okay, which is actually this one right here. Okay, I'm going to use a different color here just to show this one. Let me use a red here. What this one was is, if you look at it, I'm going to get at negative 1. It's actually at negative 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so somewhere over here. Negative 1, negative 8. Then I get 0, and it's at negative 2, right around there. Okay, then I'm going to get, that's negative 2. Then I'm going to get 1, 0, in which case here, 1, it's at 0. And then I get 2, and it's at negative 2. So 2 is at negative 2 right here. And then at 3, it's at negative 8. And so what this graph is looking like is it looks like this. Now you might be able to get this on your own by just looking at what's happening here. But the nice thing is, and again, I'm just using these coordinates here as my transformed, and it's coming from the original, okay? From the original to transform. The nice thing about doing this is I can get any graph this way. I don't have to actually rely on this, on looking at the transformations or order of operations. I'm just simply plugging it in, and I can check it for myself very quickly that I am correct.